All right, today I'm going to show how I make my Resin River drink coasters. Take a 3/8 thick piece of hardwood, cut it down to 4 inches wide by 24 inches in length, and that will get you 6 4 inch by 4 inch coasters. You go ahead and draw out your design, your river, or however you want to have filled with epoxy, because we're going to take this router and carve out the design that we drew on here. So I have a couple little puddles off to the side of the river, some islands inside the river. And so what I do is I'll clamp it to a table, so that it doesn't scoot around when I'm routing out the design. Get my router. I put in a straight cutting bit, using a plunge router. Go ahead and get to carving. Okay, now to clean up the little bit of edges there, just take a sanding. I got a flap disc here, but any kind of sanding will work. You can even use just your hand with sandpaper. Go, got it pretty cleaned up. Now we're ready for some resin. Okay, so I'm gonna be using ProMarine epoxy resin. It's a 1-to-1 mixture hardener in epoxy. Let's start off with making a total of just 2 ounces. And I'm going to be mixing in, for the first layer, I'm going to be doing graphite. And I think for the second layer, I'm going to do cherry. Might change my mind, but definitely going to do graphite for the first. If I can open the package. Alright. So, just a little splash of pigment. Well, more than a splash, but and just mix it up for, I don't know, a couple minutes. I'm only doing 2 ounces, so it's not much to mix up. Just gotta make sure you scrape the sides, get the bottom. Like I said, 2 ounces, not much to it. And then we pour. Pretty evenly spread here. Now, gotta hit it with some heat. We'll give it a few minutes and then hit it with some heat again, just to pop whatever bubbles end up popping up. And then after that, we'll let it sit for, I don't know, an hour or so, and then we'll add another coat. We'll add a clear coat, and then we'll add a little tiny bit of cherry in it to kind of swirl it in over the graphite. Okay, so now that the resin, first pour of resin has had time to sit and start to solidify, I'll prepare the second pour of resin. I'll be doing another 2 ounces. And this time, I'm going to pour about 75% of it, about 1.5 ounces, while it's just clear. And then I will add the cherry coloring to do the effects in the resin. And the clear resin is gonna let the colored resin kind of flow over the black. So once again, I'm gonna stir up the hardener and the epoxy really well. Having a nice consistent mixture is key to the curing process. Always scraping the sides of the cup, the bottom of the cup. For 2 ounces, I think that's enough stirring. We'll just do a thin layer of the clear. warming it up like that kind of thins it out. I think a cherry. In the pigment. Now for this, we'll just put it on sparingly. So, rest of this, I always keep a little silicone mold just to throw my extra resin in. Okay, I'm going to try a couple things to kind of make the pattern more interesting. Hmm. That didn't work. Probably should have added a lighter color. Let's see. This might ruin it. I don't know. We'll try. Not try to ruin it, but try a little something. That gave it a little more character. There we are. Maybe try one more down here. go. That's looking pretty good. So in a couple days I'll send it through the planer, then cut it up into coasters. Okay, now that our resin is all cured, been sitting for a couple days, a few days actually. Now we're going to send it through the planer to get this all flattened, then I'll flip it over to the other side to thin it out a little bit. Flattened out, got all the high spots of the resin out, got all the low spots even with the wood. Now we'll flip it over just to thin it out a little bit. and thin. So now, bust out the table saw. And there we go. We have our six coasters. Nice and beautiful. Now you can, fine sand them, buff them out so that the resin is all shiny. In the end, I like to put a little bit of cutting board wax on them just to really give them a shine. And after that, you're all done. Oh yeah, sometimes I'll do a little round over on the edges, depending on how thin they are. If they get too thin, if I, get a little too happy with the planer, they'll be too thin to round over the edges. But, after that, they're beautiful.